Matthew Harvey, Gracie Hurley, and Rebecca Robbins will be constructing a map by primitive means, using pace length to measure distance and an Alidade to measure angles. The map will map out the bend in the Charles River between the Elliott Bridge and the Anderson Memorial Bridge.
Our hypothesis is that we can map out the bend in the Charles River using an Alidade and pace length within 25 feet of accuracy.
The Alidade is a primitive instrument used to measure angles between sighted objects. It consists of a flat plane surface and a bar that rotates around a pivot point in the center of the base. On top of the base lies a 360-degree circular chart marked with degree intervals. An Alidade can be found on the back of other primitive instruments, such as the astrolabe.
An instrument used in conjunction with the Alidade is the theodolite. Attached to an Alidade is a telescope which rotates around the Alidade. The telescope rotates north and south to determine the angular height of stars from the horizon, and rotates around the Alidade to determine the angular measurement between sighted stars.
Originally, the Alidade was a simple ruler-shaped object with a sight marker attached to each end. As the Alidade developed, it was attached to a graduated circle marked with degrees. This allowed the measurer to set the Alidade in a horizontal plane and measure the angle between sighted objects with greater precision.
That Alidade was used in conjunction with baselines of known length to establish a control network of points running along one edge of the area to be mapped. The Alidade is then used to sight objects at each of the control points, which allows for the finding of specific objects by triangulation.
Instead of using known lengths, we counted paces between sights. Historically, pace length and calculating distance based on speed were commonly used to determine longitude for some arbitrary prime meridian. For example, the Toledo tables most likely used pace length to determine longitude. Because of our sighting locations being so close, we chose to use specific pace lengths instead of time.
We constructed our own Alidade by purchasing a round wooden base, a 3/8 inch square dowel, and printing a 360-degree graduated circle. We taped the circle to the base and nailed the dowel to the base in the center, then nailed two nails at the ends of the dowels for markers.
For pace length, Gracie and Matthew counted paces between sighting locations. After converting both pace counts to feet, we averaged the two lengths to get the measurement between sights. Gracie covered 5.12 feet per pace, while Matthew covered 7.2 feet per pace.
Our sightings began at the southwest corner of the Anderson Memorial Bridge on JFK Street. Our first step was to find true north with a magnetic compass. We then oriented the Alidade with the northing on the compass. Finally, we rotated the dowel on the Alidade to line up with distant objects to find angular measurements to the objects.
We continued west in this manner along the south bank of the Charles River. Our last measurement was taken across from the Belmont Hill in Windsor Boathouse. We then transferred our measurements to graph paper to map the course along the Charles River.
After constructing our map, we compared our map to a Google Earth map, measuring differences in distance between sighting locations.
For our statistical analysis, we calculated the differences between our pace length measurements and the actual distances between sighting locations from Google Earth. We then created a scatter plot of the estimates versus the actual measurements. Our plot almost follows a line y equals x, so our estimates were not too far off the actual measurements, with only two or three outliers existing in the measurements.
Next, a histogram was made of the differences to check for normal distribution. Since it was normal, we continued with a two-sample, two-sided hypothesis test for means. This determines if the actual measurements were statistically equal to our pace length. The p-value of 0.9 does not allow us to reject the null hypothesis that our measurements are statistically equal to the actual measurements. Thus, our measurements are within 25 feet of accuracy and our hypothesis was correct.
While our pace length measurements were very accurate, our measurements with the Alidade were not. For sites 10 through 14, the angular measurements we recorded did not align with the estimated locations of our sightings when the map was created. We believe this error was caused by three things. First, our Alidade was only 9 inches in diameter. Many of the Alidades we researched were quite large, more than a foot in diameter. It is possible that our graduated circle was too small, and our dowel to take sightings was too large to make accurate angular measurements.
Second, it is possible that our measurements were inaccurate because our alidade was not attached to a large table or flat object. The measurements that we were able to take using the bridge barriers were easier, but there is a possibility that the metal and the structures of the bridge made the compass reading inaccurate.
Finally, we used nails at the end of our dowels to line up our sightings, but most alidades have larger end pieces. These large end pieces have small openings for the navigator to align the sighted object within a very narrow line of sight. Using nails, it was much harder to align the nails, line of sight, and the sighted object all in a perfect line.
On the map we constructed, our path along the Charles is in black. Lines to objects sighted once marked are blue. Objects that our measurements place in two different locations are marked in dark blue. Objects we used multiple times and found our measurements to be somewhat accurate are marked in green. And inaccurate measurements are marked in red. Regions of uncertainty are marked in yellow.
In conclusion, our hypothesis was true for our pace length measurements, but our angular measurements with the alidade tended to be inaccurate, with no systematic error.
If this project was to be repeated, a larger alidade with a more stable surface to use would be crucial, along with a larger, more accurate sight scope on the end of the dowel.
We hope you have enjoyed our presentation.